What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to give you a whole bunch of tips to help you rank up in Halo Infinite and be a better player. A lot of shooting tips for mouse and keyboard and controller. Get your shot better, get more kills, die less. Let's get into it.
Subscribe to Active Entertainment for more content.
Now, one of the biggest things in this game that 343 has talked about, and this will be the first tip that I want to give you, is using the equipment in game. Now, you see right here, we have a thruster. A lot of you guys, I'm watching you, and you're not utilizing the equipment, and that's okay. It's going to take a while to do, but make sure you have something like a thruster. It's going to allow you to win these 1v1s with no problem whatsoever. If you're in a 1v1 fight, and the guy doesn't have a thruster, and then you pop a thruster and hit him in the face for that perfect shot, he's going to lose that fight, and you're going to win it. And on top of that, it could potentially allow you to die less as well, because you can use it as a defensive mechanic to get out of a situation too. Now, the second tip right here is a big one, but I've got many more, so make sure you stay tuned. This one is going to have to do with your shooting, okay? A lot of you are having trouble shooting your weapons, and it's not that hard to kind of whiff your shots a lot, but if you do what I tell you right now, you're going to be hitting a lot more shots in this game. And what I'm going to tell you is to move your mouse or your right thumbstick less. When you're shooting somebody, you're going to want to do something where you use your strafe to kind of aim for you, okay? If we can find this bot real quick, if not, I'll just use the wall. So when you're shooting the bot, you want to go into him. You see how I just like kind of shot into him a little bit right there? You don't want to, like, when you're shooting an object, you don't want to go like this, okay? You don't want to like try to do some crazy strafe or anything like that. You want to start the fight. If you have the first shot, you want to start the fight and just strafe into your shot, okay? See how I'm moving my mouse? Not a lot right now. I put the camera on screen as well so you can see. So I'm going to be using a keyboard and mouse here, of course, but what I'm basically saying is you have an opponent in front of you, right? So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to shoot him, but you see how I'm like not moving my mouse a lot? You see it on my screen, right? I'm keeping it steady, but I'm using my strafe to strafe into him. Do you understand? So that's a big factor in people shooting in this game is people tend to like flick their mouse around or flick their right stick around. Strafe into your shots. Use less right stick, less mouse, more WASD, more left stick. Does that make sense? For the next tip, I want to talk about positioning. This is a very, very big situation. A lot of people do not have this in mind when they're going into the game. They don't really think about their positioning, but if you really position correctly, you will never die, okay? In this situation right here, I'm shooting him. Oh no, I'm really weak. I can get out here. And then I can maybe power slide down these stairs and get out of the situation, okay? And then if my shields come back, I can come back up and I can just kill him like that. All right, so another tip I'm going to give you here is jumping, okay? You do not want to jump in Halo Infinite. It is actually very bad to jump in this game based off of a couple of factors. Number one, the strafe in this game, extremely fast, okay? There is no reason to jump. Jumping on 30 FPS in Halo 2 and Halo 3, when we're playing on console, might have been okay. But in this game, jumping, not very beneficial. On top of the fact of desync. If you don't know what desync is, essentially the server on your screen says you're around this corner, but the server on their screen still says you're right there. And desync is a problem that we've been running into for a long time, but it basically makes jumping very, very difficult. On top of the fact that I believe this is kind of rumored, not 100% factual yet, at least not been confirmed in my ears, jumping causes a little bit more bullet spread. So you get a little bit more spread in your shot as well. So overall, jumping, not a very good thing. Instead, what we talked about before, try and strafe into your shots if you're up in shots, which means you've got the first two shots, you're winning the fight. But when you're down in shots, throw in a little bit of strafe there, okay? We're down on no shields. I gotta throw that little juke in, try to out-strafe the opponent. When you're low in shields, you don't really have another choice. You're gonna have to learn to track while you're strafing fast, but when you're good and you have the advantage, make sure you do what I said earlier and strafe in your shots instead of moving your mouse or your right thumbstick. Now, this is a big one. This is keyboard and mouse and controller. This is separate for each of you. I'm gonna try and help you out and help you learn that, you know, keyboard, mouse, and controller are very different. So you have to kind of play your role, okay? As a keyboard and mouse player, at the beginning of the game, generally you have a push, for instance, on streets, and I'll do more you know, breakdowns as time goes on. But for instance, on streets, you have generally this fight down the B street, okay? There's going to be people on these stairs, and there's going to be people pushing up those stairs, okay? That's generally how it happens. Now, I'm going to have to turn around here because the bot is going crazy here, but that's generally how you have it. So, as a controller player, I would push this and be like, you know what, dude? Like, I'm getting in that fight as a controller player. I'm coming up on you. I'm letting my aim assist do some work in the close range. But as a mouse and keyboard player, I'm not doing that. As a mouse and keyboard player, I'm playing here. Okay? I'm playing up here because I have the advantage just due to the fact that mouse and keyboard in a long range fight is insane. You guys have such a big advantage long range. It's mental, okay? So if you're in a long range fight and someone's challenging you long range, if you learn how to long range shoot, which we're going to talk about in a second here, then you can literally be insane at the game on mouse and keyboard. And on a controller, if you learn how to crouch strafe mid range and just win those really close range fights, You're gonna do well as well. So, one thing for both mouse and keyboard and controller is your strafe pattern, okay? I want this to be the secondary thing you think about. I do not want it to be the first thing you think about. I want you to think about your strafe secondary, all right? More aiming with your strafe and less about trying to out-strafe the opponent, okay? So, a big thing right here is when you're in a long-range fight on mouse and keyboard, what you do is you elongate your strafe, okay? If this bot comes and pushes me here, I'll show you. But you make your strafes long, and it makes it impossible for people on controller to hit you. Mouse and keyboard is probably going to be able to beat you. But, you know, as a controller player against a mouse and keyboard player with long-range, if you elongate your strafes, which means you're making them longer, okay? There's this strafe that everyone does. This doesn't work, guys. Stop strafing like this. This does nothing, okay? This does absolutely nothing. You elongate your strafe, depending on distance, you elongate your strafe so that it's harder to hit. You can mix it up a little bit too. Throw in some, you know, left and rights there a little bit. You can see it on the keyboard screen up top. Throw in everything that you can throw in, but make sure that you're doing a better job of realizing what distance you're at and how you're supposed to shoot at that distance. On a map like Behemoth, a map that's very large, that is a mouse and keyboard player's heaven, okay? Just due to the fact that you can literally win every single long-range fight that that's put up against you. Again, this is more of a short-range fight, so I'm gonna do some shorter-range strafing, but I'm gonna solely focus on hitting that four shot first. Now, I've got many more tips to give, but this is going to be it for this video, but I have some homework for you, okay? Your homework right now is going to be, number one, to spend the entire week, this whole week, one full week, whenever you want to start, and every day you come on Halo, I want you to focus on using your right stick or your mouse less in fights. I want it to look like this when it's moving, okay? This is how I want it to look. I hope this video helped you. Again, I've got many more tip videos to give, so make sure you stay tuned. If you're on mouse and keyboard, stick to it, okay? I'm telling you right now, it's going to be a really difficult journey, but you can do it. Just stick to it. If you're not, it's all good. Controller, that works too. Stick to it. If you're just trying to get better at Halo, don't give up on it, all right? There's a lot of work that goes into this game. Halo is not like any other game out there, but I know if you put the work in, you can get where you want to be, all right? Hit that like button if this helped. Hit the subscribe button if you want more tip videos, and I will see you in the next video.
Subscribe to Active Entertainment for more content.